8:37 here, Big 550, KTRS. David Stokes is with us. He is from the Show Me Institute. Good morning, David Stokes.
Good morning, McGraw.
You were gone last week, a couple of days, out on assignment, but you came back to find out that Mayor Slay wants to raise the minimum wage to $15 an hour. However, isn't there a state law that says he can't do it?
Well, why let that stop anything? No, I don't believe there is, in that there's a law that's been passed by the legislature, and the Governor Nixon has not signed or vetoed it yet, which would do that. And I understand there's an older state law that's been found for, well, I don't know why it was found to be unconstitutional to prevent it, but
right.
it was. So that is, right now, basically, but we're waiting on the governor's signature.
Right. That aside, the mayor wants to raise the minimum wage to $15 an hour by 2020.
Oh, this is just a horrible idea. I mean, this is...
Why?
This is one of the worst ideas out of the mayor's office in his time.
Everybody gets
here.
A raise. It's a great idea.
Right. That's exactly how it works out. Just everybody gets a raise. Nobody gets laid off. No, nothing. No, if you want sort of in-depth, if your listeners out there want in-depth reasons why this is such a bad idea, I would encourage them to check out the policy studies we have at showmeinstitute.org, written by David Newmark out of the University of California. We also have some great blog posts up at showmedaily.org by Professor Rick Hafer, who's with the Southern Illinois University and does some work for us. They'll give you the in-depth details of why this is such a bad idea. I will just tell you that the idea that in the city of St. Louis we can throw the earnings tax and the payroll tax, taxes that don't exist outside of the city, mm-hmm. and now you're going to have almost double the state's minimum wage to employ workers there, and somehow that this is going to be good for the city. I mean, this notion is ridiculous. The people that don't get laid off and suddenly have more money to spend, and some people will get laid off. I would predict a sizable chunk would lose their jobs in the industries that pay minimum wage. Those that don't, you think that they're still going to then come to the county to spend all their new money, because they'll note that things have gotten awfully expensive in the city of St. Louis.
Right.
They'll just come to Walmart out on South Hanley to buy things.
Well, two things. One is an interesting study of if it costs $15 an hour to pay someone to take your order at McDonald's, they'll just automate it. So that you go in and you hit a couple of buttons. I want a Big Mac, I want fries, I want a large this, I want a large that. Hit the money, put your money in, so you can automate that person so that those jobs go away. And it's cost effective because now you're paying that person more. But secondly, we had somebody call up the show on Friday, and she said she was a small business owner. She had 47 employees, and she pays them, she said, roughly $10 an hour. So we did a little math here on my iPhone, right? So you've got 47 employees times 8 hours, right? Times 5 days a week, right? It's going to get a raise of $5, right? So every hour is $5. So times $5. Wait a minute. I did that again. Let me do 47 employees times 8 hours a day times 5 days a week times $5 an hour times 52 weeks, right?
So far seems right on.
So far. That's going to cost that woman $488,000 a year. And she said, I don't make $488,000 a year. And I said, well, you better hurry up because you're going to have to owe that here pretty soon. But a lot of people think, oh, what's a couple of extra dollars an hour? But as I said on Friday, if everybody gets a raise, nobody gets a raise.
Well, particularly the people who get fired to make up for that $488,000 hit.
Right.
They're the ones who are really, really out. Look, as President Obama's former head of the Council of Economic Advisors wrote a few years ago in an op-ed that was widely distributed, there's no such thing anymore as the company town. I mean, George Pullman is not operating in St. Louis. He doesn't employ everybody, and he and the Pullman Motor Company can increase or decrease people's wages as they see fit.
Right.
I mean, there is robust competition, to use her words, in Ms. Romer's op-ed, is the best incentive for workers out there, people competing for their labor. And when economic times are good, hardly anybody out there is making the minimum wage anyway. We need to get back to those good economic times. And the way to do that in the city of St. Louis is not to almost double the minimum wage. I mean, and what gets me so angry about it is not just the bad economic policy behind it or the desire for government to tell every business owner how to operate every aspect of their company. What gets me so angry is that so many of the people making minimum wage, either in, you know, urban areas like St. Louis or struggling rural communities that you see so much of in rural Missouri. I mean, these kids, they don't have the internship opportunities that a lot of college kids have, where they'll just get a great summer internship and they'll build the resume that way. I mean, these starting jobs are how they build that work experience, how they build that resume to go and work at McDonald's or another minimum wage place. Mm-hmm. For a few months or a year. That's how they do so much to get the job training and the work experience. And when you take away these opportunities by dramatically increasing the minimum wage, you're hurting the very people that you're trying to help. And that's what's so infuriating about it.
Aren't there so many places, though, that are paying more than minimum wage because the economy and the work environment and the work stress and the pressure on the employer to find better employees, that minimum wage, I mean, how many people pay minimum wage, which is $10 an hour, right? I mean, you hear all the time Walmart's raising their raise, McDonald's raising their numbers, because they want more qualified people and better people, and those people have other options, so naturally that hourly rate's going up.
Absolutely. You see that in the price of labor in certain industries is not set by a man in a twirled mustache sitting back and counting his money.
Right.
It's set by so many complicated factors and many industries out there. Nobody works for minimum wage because for the people needed in that industry, nobody will work for $7.50 an hour. For other industries, like most commonly talked about fast food, but plenty of others, I mean, the labor requirement and the education requirement, you get people whose labor at the time is worth $7.50 an hour. And what's great about those jobs for them is it gives them the work experience and the job training that so many people who make minimum wage, a year after they take their job, they're not at it anymore, because if they're good at it for the fast food restaurant or anywhere else, they'll get the raises and the promotions to make a better living. And
I think that's
very common, and again, we've got lots of good papers of this at showmeinstitute.org.
I would love to see that anybody who makes minimum wage in the city of St. Louis does not have to pay the 1% earnings tax. That's real money in their pocket. As opposed to everybody getting a raise, which means all the costs are going up.
The costs will go up for many of the goods that those people are needing to buy.
Right.
What's the number one argument in favor of minimum wages, and I don't support minimum wage increases at any level, federal, state, whatever. But the number one argument, if you spread it broadly, at like the federal level or at least the state, is that the people then making it will get their more money, turn around and spend it in the economy, and we see economic growth. And of course, there's some validity to that. But when you take these municipal minimum wages, like just in St. Louis,
right,
where the businesses there will bear all the pain of it, and the overall the city economy, they're not going to see the benefits of it. They'll have it throughout the whole region. It's just a terrible, terrible idea, and it would be unbelievably harmful in the city of St. Louis.
That is Director of Development David C. Stokes at the Show Me Institute. He was just David Stokes when he first came on the show. Now he's David C. Stokes. What's your middle name?
Well, according to you, the C stands for capitalism. We're just going to go for that here on the show.
There we go. All right. When can we read you? When can we see you?
We have a lot of information on minimum wages at showmedaily.org and showmeinstitute.org, and I hope your listeners check it out.
Stay tuned. Mike Isaacson next on